G'day kids, thanks for tuning in to another Aussie episode. If you haven't already, make sure you hit that subscribe button and that way you won't miss out on any of the new videos we put out, and it would certainly make my day. In the meantime, enjoy this video. Aussie, 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 oi. Ozzie is a friend of yours and he's a friend of mine.
G'day Ozzie.
G'day kids, Ozzie here. Today, we're gonna do some yard work. Now, who loves getting outside and helping in the yard? I bet you do. Following along behind Nan or Pop or Mum and Dad or any of the grown-ups really with your very own garden tools. Now, we're gonna focus on some grown-up garden tools. We've got some lawn mowers. We've got a hedger. We've got a line trimmer or a whippersnipper or as some people call it, a weed eater. And we've also got a blower or a leaf blower. Kids, it's gonna be so much fun, and today we're gonna get started with some lawn mowing. Let's get stuck in. Today we've got two different types of lawn mowers. They're both Ryobi, they're both bright green and black, and they both look really cool. But there is one main difference between the two. This one here runs on petrol power. This one here is electric or battery power. Now with the electric one, the battery one, that's where it gets its power. So you just plug that into the wall, and once that's full, pop it back in there, and she's good to go. Now there are a few other differences, but all push mowers pretty much have the same parts. So let's have a look at some of those. Now this big black thing here, that's called the deck. And on top of the deck sits the engine. Now when we're mowing the lawn, the deck can go high or low to cut the grass shorter or longer. Now to control that height, over here we have a height adjuster. So if you just push that all the way down, we're gonna cut the grass really short. If you pull it all the way up, we're gonna cut the grass quite long. Then when you're cutting the grass, the blade is under here and it cuts the grass, and all the off-cut grass comes into here. This is called the catch. Then when the catch is full, just take it off like that and dump that into the rubbish bin. Now with this electric mower, the way to start it is by pushing this button in and holding this down just like this. Now that that's off, I'm gonna show you underneath the lawnmower. So we flip it on its side. Now remember I said the engine's up here. The engine drives this thing here, and that's the blade. And when it drives it, when it's on, it spins around really, really quick. And when that spins around, it's gonna chomp through that grass and spit it out into the catch. That is the electric mower. Then kids, we have the petrol mower. Now before we start using the petrol mower, we need to make sure it's full of petrol or gas, that's right. And that's kept in here. So we're just gonna unscrew the lid and you can just look in there and I can see that it's got a little bit of petrol, but it's gonna need some more. So lucky, I've got one of these things, which is called a jerry can, and that's full of petrol. So you pull this little bit out and just really carefully. And usually, this is done by an adult, kids. And you just pour the petrol in, just like that. Okay, so once you've got enough petrol in here, pop that lid back on there, and then always make sure you put this guy back on here and screw it on really tight. All right, there's one more thing you need to check. with the petrol lawnmower, and that's called the oil. So over here, we have a little oil cap, which we can screw off, just like that. And it's got a little dipstick on the end of it. It's got a H for high and an L for low. And you can see that the level of the oil is sitting on the H. So that's got lots and lots of oil. It's good to go, which means this lawnmower is ready to be used to chomp through some of this grass. Now, when we're ready to start the lawnmower, a bit different to the electric one, we're gonna pull this lever down to where it says start. Then you need to use all your strength and you need to pull on this lever here. And that's how you start the petrol mower. When you want to stop it, you see what I just did there? Just pull that back to the stop position. Now, when you're using any of this equipment in the yard to do any of the yard work, you need to make sure that you remember safety first, of course. So we're going to put on some safety goggles and some ear protection. And then when you're using the hedger or the whippersnipper, it's also safe to use some gloves. You don't really need them for lawn mowing. But look at this yard, kids. It's looking a bit long. I think I'm ready to cut some grass. So come on, let's start with the electric one. Hey kids, that is the electric or the battery powered mower. It does a pretty sweet job, but let's have a crack at the petrol one. There you go, kids. I think this grass is looking pretty good. What do you think? But I think we need to do something else. These edges need to be done, don't they? Let's go and get that whippersnipper and do those edges. Come on. Okay, kids, I'm gonna come and grab my whippersnipper over here. This one is battery operated. So this battery just slides in and out. Down here, we have the blades. We wanna make sure we keep our fingers and hands and everything well and truly clear of those while it's running. To get it started, all you need to do is press this and then pull up on the handle. Now we want to make sure, just like with the lawnmower, we've got our safety gear on. Protect our eyes, protect our ears, and protect our hands. And now we can start cutting. There you go, kids. That's hot and sweaty work. Good thing I got my sweatband. So we've done the lawns, we've done those edges. They're looking nice and neat. We've made an almighty mess, haven't we? There's grass clippings and there's leaves everywhere. Now what are we gonna use to clean up these leaves? A leaf blower. So let's go and grab that and get all this cleaned up. Come on. Okay, kids, I've got my trusty leaf blower here. This one is also battery powered and it's the same battery that the whippersnipper used. So we can just take that, pop it in there, she's good to go. This one's pretty simple. All you do is press that button and off she goes. But let's protect our ears, shall we? So we'll put our ear muffs back on and we'll protect our eyes at the same time with our glasses. We're good to go. So there you go, kids. That's the leaf blower. Things are looking pretty clean around here. And leaf blowing is one of my favorite things to do. It was always my favorite when I was a kid because it's really easy to do and you can't really get it wrong. It's very, very safe. So if you want to try one of these things at home with your grown up, leaf blower is the way to go. And you know the best thing about it? It means you're almost finished. Now there is one more piece of equipment that I had over there, and that was, do you remember? It was a hedge trimmer, wasn't it? There's a mighty big hedge over there and needs a lot of trimming. So come on, come and help me with the hedge trimming. Let's go. Righto, kids. The next thing up is our hedge trimmer, or our hedger. Now this guy uses the same battery as the whippersnipper and the blower. Pretty handy, hey? Just pop that on there, that's good to go. Now this is a very important part of this hedge trimmer. That's because it protects you from cutting yourself on the blades. This is a tool that should only be used by grown-ups. Now the safety feature is this little button here, or this big button here. You grab that and then you press these two buttons. And just like that, these things go back and forth really, really fast, and that's what chops through the hedges. So, safety first, of course. We're gonna put our ear protection and our eye protection on, and also protect our hands. And then, we can start trimming this hedge. Perfect. There you go, kids. I reckon this hedge is looking pretty good. And I reckon this whole yard is looking pretty amazing. Thanks so much for your help. Thanks for joining me today. Remember, when you're helping out in the yard with grown-ups, maybe start with just your toys or even the blower. That's a really good one to start when you're a little kid. Kids, I hope you've enjoyed it. I hope you've learnt lots. And I hope that you've had lots of fun in the yard just like I have. We'll see you on our next video. And until then, stay keen. I've got some leaves to rake up. G'day kids and grown-ups. If you are loving watching and learning with Ozzie, it would be amazing if you could please do me a really big favour and just tell anybody else that you think might enjoy it too. In the meantime, enjoy this brand new episode, and as always, stay keen. Ozzie, 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 oi. Ozzie is a friend of yours and he's a friend of mine. G'day kids, Ozzie here. Now I am just a little bit excited today. I am in my happy place because we've come along to Prompt Mowers and we're gonna learn all about lawn mowers, but not just your push lawn mowers. We're gonna go straight to the big bad boys, the ride-on lawn mowers. I'm super keen, kids. Come and check these out. Let's go. So kids, we've got three different types of lawnmowers to talk about today. We've got more of your traditional type here. This is a ride-on mower, or otherwise known as a lawn tractor. The one in the middle, that's a zero turn. And then the one down the end, that's a rear engine or a front cutter. So let's start with this lawnmower, kids. I reckon this one's gonna be one of my favorites. Can you guess why? That's right, it's green and gold, just like Ozzie. So this is a John Deere ride-on lawnmower or a lawn tractor. Check this out. This is the chute. So when the grass is cutting, the grass is gonna come out the chute. Got a nice yellow seat. Looks comfy, doesn't it? If we lift that up, see that there? That's where the petrol goes. Got this lever over here. Can you see that? That controls the deck height. Goes up and down. Just like that. All right, this one here, that's a brake. So when you're not driving it, and you don't want it to roll anywhere, gotta make sure you put the brake on. But check this out, this is where the engine is. I can open it up and have a look inside. Look at that, kids. So that's the engine, that's what's gonna drive this thing. Goes pretty fast, and that's the battery. That's how you start it. Close that one back up again. But let's jump on, shall we? So you just sit up here when you're driving it, and it's a steering wheel just like a car. Okay, then you've got a lever here, push it forward to go a little bit faster. Can you see the picture down here? It's a picture of a hare and a tortoise. Which one do you think is gonna go faster? That's right, the hare is gonna be faster. You push it forward, make that engine spin faster, and then the tortoise will make it go a little bit slower. All right, that's pretty much everything. Should we fire it up and go for a drive? Let's do it, kids. So that, kids, that's a ride-on lawnmower. How much fun is that? Let's go and check out the zero turn. So, kids, this is a zero turn. So, what looks different to you? Well, it's red, of course, so does that make go faster, maybe? I don't know, maybe. But is there a steering wheel on this one? No, that's right, there's no steering wheel. That's because you steer using these things. These cool levers here. Everything else looks pretty similar, but there's no engine on the front. Is there? There's an engine on the front on that one, but the engine is on the back. Come check it out. So we've got the engine sitting on the back of this one. But other than that, you've got the chute that comes out the side. You've got the deck underneath. That's what cuts the grass. It does look a little bit bigger, doesn't it? So that's because the blades are bigger. So it's probably going to cut a little bit more grass. And it is going to go a little bit faster. Not because it's red, but that's because it's got a bigger engine. But let's jump on and check out how it goes. Okay, kids, so there's no steering wheel on this guy. That's because this is essentially a steering wheel. So when you want to go forward, you push it forward. When you want to go backwards, you push it backwards. But these things move individually like that because this one on the right controls the right rear wheel. This one on the left controls the left rear wheel. And that's why it's called a zero turn, because if you push them in opposite directions, you can do super quick turns on the spot in a zero spot. Zero turn, that makes sense? All right, we've got some other controls down here. You've got the park brake, you've got that hare and the tortoise again. So that's forwards and backwards to make the engine rev and spin quicker. Okay, you've got the choke here. So you need to have the choke on to start it, and you need to have these guys open to start too. You've got a pedal down here, and that controls the deck height. So up and down, how short or how long you want the grass. All right, I think we're ready to give this thing a go. Should we try and start it? Let's go, kids. Woo-hoo-hoo! is a whole lot of fun. Kids, you see those tight little circles I was doing? That's because of the way it drives. And that's the difference between this one and the ride-on mower or the lawn tractor. Let's go and check out this one over here. This one is the rear engine or the front cutter. Let's check out the differences on this one. So when you turn the steering wheel, it's the back wheels that turn. And that makes it really good for getting in around tight places like trees and stuff. Now this is where the engine is. Come check this out. So the engine sits at the back, so behind where the driver sits, which is really good because all the noise and the heat and all the smoke comes out the back. So it's a bit more comfortable to drive. So we've got this lever here, and check that out. That controls the deck height. And with the deck, the cutting deck at the front, it means you can get in under bushes, so you can drive in and cut under shrubs and bushes and stuff. You've also got the blade height here, so how close you're cutting the grass. And you've got the other controls here. You've got that hare and tortoise again, and you've also got the start and stop switch there. Come around here, you've got, that's where the petrol goes, or the fuel. And you check out, this is where the cutting deck is, but you can see that there's no chute. So with no chute, the grass has nowhere to go, so the grass goes back through the blades and gets cut again. So it's like mulching it as well as cutting it, and it doesn't leave a big spread of grass in its trail. So come on, let's check it out, what it's like when we start it. We've got the foot brake here, and we've got an accelerator to go forward, and this pedal is to go backwards. Let's start it up, see how we go. Ooh, I like the sound of this one. All right, we'll take the foot brake off. Check out those wheels. So you can see how it like turns in the middle. All right, let's go for a little spin. Look at that. That's cool. That's cool, isn't it? Different types of ride-on mowers. Which one's your favorite? Yeah, we've got the ride-on mower down the end there, which is also known as a lawn tractor. We've got the zero turn. We've got this one that we're sitting on here, which is the rear engine or the front cutter. Yeah, I quite like the green and gold. I quite like how fast the zero turn is, but I reckon this guy would be pretty fun to cut some grass in. So kids, what do you reckon we should do right now? Let's go do what lawn mowers do best. Let's cut some grass. All right, we're gonna engage. Woo-hoo-hoo! Thank you. There you go, kids. How much fun is it when you get to cut the grass on a ride-on lawnmower just like this? I hope you've learnt lots about ride-on lawnmowers. I hope you've had lots of fun today. I certainly have. We'll see you on our next video. Until then, stay keen. Hey kids, did you have lots of fun today watching Ozzie?
I hope so.
Did you know that we've got a heap of Ozzie episodes on our YouTube channel? If you haven't already, go back and have a scroll through. I reckon you'll find some others that you absolutely love. And while you're there, why don't you hit subscribe? That way you won't miss out on any of our new videos that we bring out. We'll see you again soon, kids. Until then, stay keen. Oh, and by the way, did you happen to find the hidden Ozzie icon in that video? Yeah, make sure you look closely because they're in every single video. That's right, stay keen, kids. Ozzie, 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 oi. Ozzie is a friend of yours and he's a friend of mine. G'day kids, Ozzie here. I hope you've been having lots of fun today, because I certainly have. Guess where I've been? I'm here at Capital City Waste Services and the guys have let me come down to check out a real life garbage truck. But do you see anything different about this garbage truck? That's right, it's a little bit smaller. It's a compact truck. It's called a junior truck and it's designed that way so that it can go under big tall buildings but into the car parks so it can get to the places that the big mummy and daddy trucks over the back there can't get to. But it can do everything the same that the big trucks can do, just on a smaller scale. So the guys have been super good to us. They've let us come down and Ozzie's even been allowed to have a drive and they've even let us bring you along so that we can go and check things out together. So come on, let's go and see the different things that the garbage truck can do. Let's go. All right, let's go and have a look around the truck before we get into any detail. So we've got some controls here. They make things move and lift things up. Oh, I think that's hand sanitizer. Make sure your hands are clean after you've touched the rubbish in the bins. Over here, we've got the lever and some buttons. They control this tailgate. And the rubbish goes in here. It gets all squashed up in there and it goes inside. Come around here. Got some more buttons and controls here. So many buttons on this truck. So up here, we've got lots of flashing lights all around the truck. We've got the petrol tank or the fuel tank. Oh, and this guy here, I've been told don't open this if there's rubbish inside because that's where the rubbish lives. And if you open it when it's full, you're gonna get rubbish all over yourself. That's not fun. All right, we've got some gloves to protect our hands. We've got a shovel and a broom so that we can push any excess rubbish out. And then this guy, it's a fire extinguisher. So safety first, if anything goes wrong when you're out there with the truck, you gotta make sure you can put it out with the fire extinguisher. And we're back to the cab. Why don't we jump inside and see all the different controls and see what happens inside there. Let's go. So this is the front of the garbage truck. This is what's called a cab. Looks like a pretty standard truck, doesn't it? But the difference is, down here, we've got all these fun controls that help us control everything at the back of the truck. But nothing's gonna work until we start the engine, so let's fire it up. All right, these buttons down here are our two important ones. That puts power to everything, and that helps turn everything on too. Now, two buttons which control the safety features of the truck, are these two. That's going to turn on our flashing lights to make sure that people know where we are and keep us safe. And these three buttons, they control things like the blade inside the truck, which pushes the rubbish backwards and forwards. And this guy picks up the tailgate and puts it back down again. And this last button helps us pick up the bins to dump the rubbish inside the back of the truck. Why don't we go back there and check it all out and see how it works? Come on, let's go get some bins. All right, we're seen inside the cab, and let's go down the back for the fun part. So we've got our flashing lights going. Let's go and pick up some bins. Now here we have these two guys, 240 litres each. This might be a small truck, but it can pick up a lot of stuff. Let's go around this side. We'll show you how it works. So we've lined the bins up, which is really important to make sure that this lifter or the grabber arm can pick the bins up and dump the rubbish into the hopper. Over here, we've got the lever. When we press that, up go the bins. Out goes the rubbish. Then we bring him back down. And then check this guy out. So this big strong arm's gonna come down, pick it up, and scoop it up. And take it up and dump it inside the body of this little junior truck. And it sits inside there in the compression body. So that's two of those little bins. But this little beast can also pick up a big bin. I'll show you. Look, green and gold, just like Ozzie. So, same thing. It's gonna line it up with that arm so the grabber arm can come up and pick the bin up by its handles. Up goes the bin. Out goes the rubbish. And look, it's empty now. And then this big strong arm comes down and it's gonna scoop it up for us. And just like that, we say, see you, rubbish. So it's gone up inside the compression body. Now, why don't we come down here and see what else this baby can do? Come on. So we've picked up some bins from the back there because this little guy is a rear loader. And the rubbish has gone inside the truck into the compression unit. Now, when we've finished picking up rubbish for the day, we're gonna go back to the tip and we're gonna use this guy to clear the truck of rubbish. So let's have a look at these controls. So this one here, it's gonna lift up the back of the truck for us. Look at that tailgate going up, up, up into the air. So once that tailgate's up nice and high, we're gonna push the blade back inside and that's gonna push the rubbish out the back. Check that out. All right, looks all clear down this end. All right, so once that blade's pushed all the rubbish out and the truck's nice and empty, we're gonna bring that tail back down. So there's one more button here, and that's this big bright red one. And that's in case something's going wrong. If for some reason something's getting stuck inside, you quickly hit that stop button, and that's gonna stop anything from moving, going up and down, or back and forward. So that's it. That's our junior truck. We've picked up the bins. We've brought the rubbish back to the tip. We've emptied the truck. Now this guy's ready to pick up some more rubbish. Come on, let's go. So there you go, kids, another super exciting visit. I hope you've had as much fun as I have. This has been super exciting, getting to drive the little junior truck and operate the controls that pick up the bins and empty the truck at the end of the day. Two more really important things to keep you safe. It's okay to be fascinated with trucks, I certainly am, but make sure you never get too close to the garbage truck. They're big, they're heavy, and they can do some damage if you get too close. And number two, although it might look like a bit of fun, never chase a garbage truck down the street, because that is very dangerous, especially if the garbage truck driver doesn't know you're there. Okay, hope you've had lots of fun. We'll see you again soon in the next video with Ozzie. Until then, stay keen. Hey kids, did you have lots of fun today watching Ozzie?
I hope so.
Did you know that we've got a heap of Ozzie episodes on our YouTube channel? If you haven't already, go back and have a scroll through. I reckon you'll find some others that you absolutely love. And while you're there, why don't you hit subscribe? That way you won't miss out on any of our new videos that we bring out. We'll see you again soon, kids. Until then, stay keen. Oh, and by the way, did you happen to find the hidden Ozzie icon in that video? Yeah, make sure you look closely because they're in every single video. That's right. Stay keen, kids. Ozzie, 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 oi. Ozzie is a friend of yours and he's a friend of